self-esteem. Self-esteem is a person's opinion about himself or herself. It is a term used in psychology to reveal a person's overall evaluation or appraisal of his or her own worth. Self-esteem encompasses beliefs and emotions such as triumph, despair, pride, and shame. High self-esteem is a good opinion of oneself, and low self-esteem is a bad opinion of oneself. Self-esteem is crucial and is a foundation of a positive attitude towards life. It influences how one thinks, acts, and relates to other people. Low self-esteem results in poor confidence and causes negative thoughts. People with low self-esteem give up easily and find it difficult to face challenges. Self-esteem is the disposition of experiencing oneself as competent in coping with the basic challenges of life and as being worthy of happiness. There are two components to Brandon's definition. The first he calls self-efficacy, confidence in the functioning of my mind, in my ability to think, understand, learn, choose, and make decisions. Confidence in my ability to understand the facts of reality that fall within the sphere of my interests and needs. Self-trust, self-reliance. The second is self-respect. Self-respect means assurance of my value, an affirmative attitude towards my right to live and be happy, comfort in appropriately asserting my thoughts, wants, and needs. The feeling that joy and fulfillment are my natural birthright. Low self-esteem is the result of a poor self-image. Self-image is based on how one sees oneself. Do you think you are a good, trustworthy, diligent, sincere, or sociable person? Do you believe you look good, or you feel that others look better or dress better than you do? Job factors can affect your self-esteem. Do you value the job you do? Are you satisfied with your job? Do your colleagues respect you? If you have high self-esteem, you will be confident, happy, and highly motivated to succeed. Self-image. Self-image is how you see yourself. This may be how you see yourself physically or your opinion of who and what you are. Self-image is important as it affects your self-esteem and confidence. Self-image includes what you think you look like, how you see your personality, what kind of person you think you are, how much you like yourself or you think others like you, your perception of what others think of you, the status you feel you have. Self-esteem is how you feel about yourself. Image is about how you see yourself and how you believe others see you. These are closely connected because if you have a poor opinion of yourself, your self-esteem would be low. Image is related to perception. Your perception about yourself affects how you behave, think, and relate to others. Your confidence depends on your self-image. Your perception about yourself is different from others' perception about you. Your view of yourself is a distorted one, as you would see yourself in a positive or negative light according to your level of self-esteem. Ways to improve self-image. List down all the things that you like about yourself, like your looks, personality, and abilities. Focus on your positive thoughts and try to forget the negative things that happened to you. Note down when people compliment you. Find out why you perceive yourself the way you do. Make sentences that you feel would help you improve your self-image. For instance, clothes, looks, hairstyle, and outlook towards things. Take feedback and criticism in a positive manner and try to improve yourself. Take yourself less seriously and cheer up. Take challenges to surprise yourself. Self-acceptance. Self-acceptance means accepting one's feelings, thoughts, and actions and loving oneself. Self-acceptance entails our willingness to experience, that is, to make real to ourselves without denial or evasion that we think that sort of what we think, feel what we feel, desire what we desire, have done what we have done, and are what we are. Acceptance exists at the core of our being. We can choose to accept ourselves as we are without focusing too much on our weaknesses. For self-acceptance, first we need to recognize the things that we are not able to accept about ourselves. We need to examine each of these things and find out the beliefs that are stopping us to accept those things. Then, one by one, scrutinize each issue and try to resolve it. Be aware of yourself and your beliefs. Check your honesty level. Make sure and accept that you are giving your best. Relax your value judgments. Scrutinize your guilt feelings and try to remove them. Find out the things that motivate you. There are two steps to accept yourself. First, you have to make a choice that you want to accept yourself. Once you are able to make this decision, you need to be aware about it always. I.e., in your day-to-day life, observe yourself and do not judge yourself all the time. Self-observation without judgment will help you see yourself as you are, with your strengths and weaknesses. Self-acceptance is one of the most important steps for a healthy self-esteem. It would help you love what you like and sense what you want to sense.